So today that we will study domain and ranges. As usual, I had explained that to you better, that domain of a relation, that is the set of values with respect to x-axis, okay? So that means, so whatever points that will be on x-axis, that will be the domain. Means suppose that you can also understand in this way, suppose if any point is given to you, that is 3, 4. So 3 will be your domain in that point, okay? That means the value of x, that will be your domain. And secondly, whatever will be the value of y, that will be your range, okay?
Yeah.
Understand?
Yeah.
And notation on x or y axis, that means, so we can understand here, that means domain and range of a relation are often described using the set notation or ordered pair or the number line graph. Suppose that you are seeing here, if two variables are A and B, okay, if two variables are A and B with respect to a set, then in that way, suppose that x is the third variable in that set, then we can write that a is less than or equals to x is less than or equals to b. Okay? I am repeating my words again. If a, b are the ordered pair and x is any variable between a and b, then you can define that number between a and b, that is x, like a is less than b, a is less than or equals to x is less than or equals to b. Understand?
Yeah.
Clearly you can understand that if x is between a and b, so it will belongs to a and b, okay? So that's why there is a dark circle between A and B. Here you are seeing, are you able to see my moving cursor on your screen?
Yes.
Okay. And the next is, so it is between, so when x is between, then your graph, your number line graph, that will be like this. If that will be outside, okay, if x will be outside, then in that way it will be written as x is less than A and x is greater than b. For left hand side, okay, that is less than, and for right hand side we have to write greater than. You can see here, for left hand side there is a hollow circle, because that means you are not including the value of a in x, okay? Understand?
Yes, sir.
And also here, x is greater than b. Greater than b, that means you are taking right hand side. Also, you are not including the value b in x. Then you can also, with respect to a and b, you can write that x belongs to, in close bracket, negative infinity. Okay? And also, a belongs to union B, A union B, okay, or A belongs to B intersection infinity, okay, open bracket of B, that means you are not including the value of B there, okay, understand?
Can you tell me one second?
Yes, I can explain that again. Here, beta, they are saying x belongs to, in open parenthesis, minus infinity, and a in close, a or b, okay, and infinity, and in. So here they are explaining their range here, okay, that means the value that belongs to negative infinity to a, okay, but a is not included, and positive infinity to b, but b is not included there, okay? Understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so next is, also beta set notation they are explaining regarding to that what that set means. They are also explaining here set notation. Suppose that in set builder form you are seeing here x as then x is greater than or equals to 3. It means that the value of x that is equals to 3 or greater than 3. So that means clearly you can assign that interval notation like x belongs to close parenthesis 3 to infinity. Okay?
Mm.
3 to infinity. Why after infinity there is open parenthesis? Open parenthesis is there because it is limitless. Okay? That's why there is open parenthesis. Okay? If you will do close parenthesis over here, that means the value will be close over there. But as usual, you know that if any value that would like to be from something, from some point to infinity, so that means infinity you can't consider, okay? So that's why there will be a open bracket also. So open bracket both will be there, okay? 3 to infinity, okay? Also greater than or equals to, so there will be dark circle on 3, okay? And then your line that will be there. So this arrow line that indicates that you can take any value after 3 as the value of x there, okay? Also, what it means? It means that the set of all x such that x is greater than or equals to 3, okay? Its value is this one. Simply you can understand x as the next is greater than or equals to 3. That means x belongs to the value. X belongs to the value 3 and greater than 3. Either any of the value greater than 3 that you can also take. Okay? Either you can take equal to 3 or either you can take greater than 3. Okay?
Yeah.
Also, next is x as then x is less than 2. Less than 2, that means left hand side that you have to see. So less than 2, that means minus infinity to less than 2. But less than 2, that means 2 you don't have to include. So there will be hollow circle. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
That means x, in x, there will be all the values from negative infinity to less than 2. That means up to 1. Okay, but 2 will not included in that. So that's why you can see that on number line you are seeing this one. Negative infinity to 2. But there is a hollow circle there. That means you are not including that value. Okay?
No.
Clear, beta?
Yes, sir.
Third one, x as then minus 2 is less than x is less than or equals to 1. Beta, here they are explaining range. Okay. Here is range. So that means on number line you have to show that minus 2 is less than. So at minus 2 there will be hollow circle and at 1 there will be dark circle. So you can see clearly here. Yes. What I am showing you here. At minus 2 there is hollow circle, at 1 there is dark circle. Okay. That means the value of x that is in between minus 2 to 1, in which one we don't have to include minus 2, but the value of x that can be 1 also, okay, less than 1 or equals to 1. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Are you understanding? Gautam, are you understanding, beta?
Just tell me 1 second, sir.
Okay, beta, they are saying x as then minus 2 is less than x is less than or equals to 1. Firstly, you can see that half part of it. Half part of it. Up to here. Minus 2 is less than x. What does it mean? That means the value of x that will be minus 2. Value of minus 2 that is less than x. That means the value of x that will be greater than minus 2. Clear?
No.
So you don't have to include minus 2 in x. Okay, and in next half you can see there x is less than or equals to minus 1, and the value of x that will be equals to 1 or less than 1. So that's why at minus 2 there will be a hollow circle, and at 1 there will be a dark circle. Okay? Dark circle and hollow circle concept is only that when there will be less than or equals to or greater than or equals to, then there will be dark circle. If there will be only less than or greater than, then you have hollow circle over there at that point. Clear? Now you understand?
Yes, sir.
And also when there will be equals to, then you have to do a, you have to write close bracket, okay? And when the value is not assigned properly, then you have to open bracket over there, okay? Like you can see that close bracket of minus 2, okay? That means they are not taking this value, okay? And close value of 1, that means they are taking 1 as value of x, okay? Or simply you can understand that the set of or the value of x that will lie between minus 2 and 1, in which 1 will be included, okay? Understand now?
Sir, one thing I didn't understand, sir.
What?
When should we put inside bracket and close bracket?
Oh, that means this one here. That means x belongs to close bracket minus 2 and close bracket 1. Close bracket, are you asking this one?
Yeah, close bracket and...
Yes, but a close bracket, that close bracket minus 2, that means they are not including this value over here, okay? And close bracket 1, that means they are assigning value of x as 1, okay? You can see that. Here, in your previous one, x is less than 2. That means open close bracket of minus infinity, that means either any value that you can take, and also open bracket of 2 there. That means they are not including value 2. If there will be close bracket, so that means they are including value 2. But if there is open bracket again, so that means they are not including that value 2 also. Understand?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yeah, clear.
Also, you can understand, if you are not understanding, then you can understand the previous one also. Here you are, you can see that x belongs to, x is greater than or equals to 3. So you can assign that x belongs to open bracket 3, okay? But you can see that again, when you will reach infinity, then open bracket is also there. That means any value that you can assign there, okay? Understand?
Yeah.
Now, the last one is, x less than x is less than or equals to 0. Okay. So, less than or equals to 0. So, that means you have to move on left hand side. Okay. You have to move on left hand side. Give me one second, please. Hello. Sorry for interruption. Okay, so here, Pratan, x less than x is less than or equals to 0. It means simply you can understand less than, that means left hand side that you have to assign your value of x. And also less than or equal, that means 0 will be included, the value of x over there. Clear? You can see that on number line 0 there is a dark circle and left arrow is there. Clear? Also, union, x is greater than 4, that means x is greater than 4, that means you can clearly understand that the value of 4 that they are not including as x, okay? You can simply understand whatever that is written here, the set of all the values of x, the set of all the values, set of all x such that x and that is in between x to 4. Okay. That means all the values of x that will lie between 0 to 4. Okay. In this one, 0 is included, but 4 is not included. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay. So the next one that is here. Do you understand clearly?
Yes, sir.
Okay. To find the domain and range of the function. Okay. Suppose that any function is given. So how will you judge that what will be its domain and range? So clearly you can see that suppose that this type of graph that is given to you. Okay. So clearly you can see that there is a dark circle over minus 1 and minus 3. Okay. So here value of x that is minus 1. So always remember dark circle is there. That means x is greater than or equals to minus 1. Understand? So the domain that will be x less than x is greater than or equals to minus 1. Clear? Beta, you are seeing this point or not?
No, minus 1, minus 1.
Also, there is dark circle there is all now.
No.
Okay? So, dark circle that means what? Whatever will be the value of x, that will be greater than or equals to. Okay?
Yeah.
Greater than or equals to. So clearly that you can understand that if there will be any number x that will be between minus 1 and minus 3, so x is greater than or equals to minus 1. Clear? With respect to x value. Okay? And y is greater than or equals to minus 3 with respect to y. That means clearly your domain will be x belongs to minus 1 to infinity. Okay? You can see here. X belongs to minus 1 to infinity. Okay? So open bracket of minus 1. That means you are in starting value from minus 1. Including minus 1 as the value of x. And open bracket of infinity. That means you are not including infinity over there. Means any value of infinity that you can take there. Clear?
Yeah.
Also, here y is minus 3. Y is minus 3. That means y is greater than or equals to minus 3. It means you are assigning domain and range of a function. Domain and range of a function fundamentally that you have to keep in your mind that if there will be domain and range, you have to obtain. So there will be a point given in which one the value of x that will be your domain and the value of y that will be your range. Clear?
Yeah.
But dark and hollow circle will also define that either that will be greater than or equals to or less than or equals to, or that will be greater than or less than. Understand?
Yes.
If that will be dark circle, so 100% you have to understand that you have to assign that greater than or equals to. That's why you can see that here they are writing x is greater than or equals to minus 1. Okay?
Uh-huh.
And also there domain that you can also write that x less than x missing set builder form. Do you know about sets?
Sets
set theory?
Yeah, also I didn't learn till now.
Oh my god. Oh, okay. But fundamentally I can tell you one thing that sets that is defined as the collection of objects, okay? Or simply you can understand, and also there are three types of sets. First one is a roster form, second one is your set builder form, and third one is your descriptive form. So here you are seeing that whatever that I shade here as blue, so it is your set builder form. So that means when you will define set in set builder form, so you have to write like x less than x like that. Okay? Understand? So x less than x is greater than or equals to minus 1, or you can define that x belongs to minus 1 to infinity over there. Okay? Y value that you can also assign there that y all the values of y that is greater than or equals to minus 3, same as x, you can also define as y, that is y such then y that is greater than or equals to minus 3. Clear?
Mm-hmm.
Beta, are you understanding this one clearly?
Yes, sir.
Pardon?
Yeah, clear. I understand.
Okay, okay. That's great. That's great. So, come to the next figure. I explained that to you. In the second one, it is your parabolic graph. That means your function will be in quadratic form. Okay? You can understand clearly. Okay. It is downwards parabola. Okay? So, that means the coefficient of x square, that will be negative number. Firstly, you have to understand this one. Okay? Your graph is downwards. Okay? Downward opening. Downward opening, that means the value, the coefficient of x square, that will be a negative number. Okay? If that will be upward opening, then your coefficient of x square, that will be positive number. So here, you can understand that x, that means domain, can be take any value. That means you can see that there is an arrow like, okay? So downward opening, that means up to how much that it would like to enlarge, okay? So you cannot define clearly that what will be the value of x. So always remember that when this type of situation will be, then your domain will be x as then x belongs to real number, okay? That means any value of x that you can take over there, okay? Understand, beta?
Yes, sir.
Also, you can see that there is maximum point that is given 2 comma 1 here. Wait a second, sorry. 2 comma 1 that is given here. Sorry, I am not able to select. Yes. 2 comma 1. What does it mean? It is maximum point of this parabola. Maximum point, that means here you can see that the value of y, okay, value of x that you defined, that it is x belongs to real number, okay? That means your domain, that would like to be real number, okay? And you can see that y is 1, so that means y cannot be greater than 1, okay? So the range that you can define as range, you can define as y is such then y is less than or equals to 1, because 1 you are including there also. That's why you can write that its range will be less than or equals to 1. Okay? You can also understand in this way, beta, your parabola that is opening downwards, okay, and it will go up to infinity. That's why any value of x that you can assign there, okay.
But you told downwards is negative, no, sir.
Pardon?
Downwards is negative, no. But here positive is there.
Beta, downwards, that you can move up to anywhere. That's why that any real number that you can take as the domain of x. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
And here you can see that up to 1. You can see that maximum point is 2 comma 1. Okay? 2 comma 1, that means the maximum value of y that can be 1 over there, okay? So that means the range that will not exceed, okay, 1, that will not exceed than 1. So that means you can write there y such then y is less than or equals to 1. That means you are including the value 1 as value of y, and maximum value of y that will be 1. Clear?
Yeah.
That means your range will be minus infinity. It is downwards. So minus infinity. Upward opening, that means plus y that will be there. Downward opening, that means minus y will be there. Okay? So that means minus infinity to 1, that will be its value. Understand?
Yeah.
So that means your range that they are also defining here, y belongs to closed interval of minus infinity to 1. Closed interval of 1 they are taking because they are taking the value 1. Okay? Final value of y there. Okay? Do you understand this one? Parabolic graph?
Yes.
Okay. Well, if you will understand this one, beta, then 100% you will be able to get the range and domain of any type of figure that will be given. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
Yes. And most important thing is that it is your parabola. So equation will be in quadratic form. In quadratic form also, that when you were studying in past, then I explained that when I was explaining graph to you, then I told you that if your parabola is downward opening, that means the coefficient of x square, that will be negative. Or just like as minus 2x square, minus 3x square, okay, like that. So that means that your domain, that will be up to infinity, okay, any value that you can take. So that's why that x, they are writing here x belongs to R. Okay, that means your domain is your real number. And range, you can see that your parabola is maximum at maximum 0.2, 1. So that means your maximum value of y, that can be up to 1 there. Okay, that's why you can take that either that will be less than or equals to 1. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, that's good. Now, here. Just see the third one. In third one, you can see that it is your graph that is given. Okay, x can take all values except 2. Okay, x can take all values except 2. Because 2 you can't take. You are seeing this dotted line over here. This dotted line at x equals to 2 and y equals to 1 over there. That means you don't have to take the value of x as 2 and y as 1. Okay? So clearly you have to understand that the domain, that will be all the values of x. Okay?